Three, two, one, go! Full thrust. Been full thrust a while ago, but whatever. I'm going away from the sun. That's all that really matters.
Yeah, you're gonna win. Okay, everyone, welcome back. I'm doing a distance challenge with Calbiri and Kerbal, and I have no clue what I'm doing, so this is gonna be interesting. Got Cal's up in the top right there, a slight delay. And so no docking or anything, just one rocket. How far can we go?
Should we send extra Kerbals along? I think I should send extra Kerbals along. Just to be a bastard about it.
Well, I suppose if I'm going to go far, I need a lot of fuel, right?
Well, the more fuel you put on it, the better, but at the same time, you still have to get into space, so what's really important is your delta, right? It's how much fuel compared to how much mass you have.
Okay.
We need one of these sets. Fuel tank. There we go. Oh, I like this little snub thing. Ooh, look at that. There's all these parts, it's like toys. I can't help it. I know what we need. We need a connector. So that means we're gonna want that's, where is it? Down structural. Yes. It's in structural. Where's the thing? We want a big one, don't we?
Yeah.
Just like that. And we're gonna pop it on. We want not symmetry, but we do want angle snap. Angle snap is what makes it go nice and squared off where you want it. Now, apparently, I can't watch your stream, Tom. Is my stream lagging? It might
no,
be too
fine.
Much.
No, it's fine.
Try and watch yours and run mine.
Oh, really? Well, it's you're coming through nice.
Okay, then I'm just having trouble watching yours. All right, that's all I'm worried about. Is, you know, like, will mine actually keep working?
It looks good.
What the crap? Why is it trying to stick it on that? Apparently, it does not like to attach the fuselage to, it does, yeah, never mind. Just derp. That's what I'm dealing with, derp. Okay, so we have that. Let's put on some engines. What kind of engines should we go for? What's the most efficient ones? That's the atomic rocket, right?
My screen is bottom left, guys. And Cal is in the top right, you can tell, because he's got a ship and I've got, like,
Bits.
I've got like one bit. I've got two unconnected bits that are the wrong size.
You could put in monopropellant engines, try and get into space while being green. Cause burning rocket fuel is dabble. What? Ooh, big engine. Not good for space though. Vacuum. There we go. That's the stat I'm looking for. Engine ISP in vacuum. And I'm pretty sure 800 is the best one. Except for ion, because nobody uses ion. Actually, it's a pretty good system if you're light enough. That's cheating, though. Well, I suppose if you get an ion system up there and going, and you manage to, you know, do it, then hey. But ions are boring.
Right.
I don't know. I want to do the nuclear engine, but it looks kind of derpy.
Yeah.
Do you know how to solve that, Tom?
No.
I know how to solve that. Watch this. If I can find the right part. Nope, that's not the right part. That one's just a little too short. Come on, I've done this 100 times. You can embed parts if you're careful. They're betting on me, Tom. It's because I'm using shinies.
Are you sure?
Hey, I'm just saying that they're the ones betting. I didn't have nothing to do with it.
They're probably making a safe bet, though.
I don't know. Just watch. Maybe mine won't even get off the ground. You know? Whatever, we'll use the big one.
Lol.
Okay. And we got those in.
Wonder why it's switched upside down.
What is this? The burner engine.
It's clearly not supposed to be that way out.
Oh! It uses your normal thrust instead of RCS. That's some powerful exhaust there. That's for big ships. I'm not going for a big ship. Okay, there we go. Let's not do that. Let's just go for that.
Lol.
What?
Just put something massive on top of it.
Don't make it fall over, Tom.
Where'd you get that ring thingy for popping off?
For popping what off?
You know, so that it doesn't like take the whole ship with it.
Oh, the ejector? That's in your structural tab. Radial decoupler. There's several other decouplers.
Oh, that's the one I want then.
But that's what you're looking for, the decouplers in your structural tab.
Do you have to put two of them down, or just one?
Each one counts as a stage, so that's up to you.
Oh no, I just mean for the one breakpoint.
Each one is one stage, so that's up to you. I have no idea what this part is. I'm just putting it in because it's big. Hey, look at that. It fits. I have no idea which one of these parts I do and don't want to have. There we go.
What the hell is the difference between the nuclear one and the other one? What?
Their efficiency rates. If you right click when you're looking at them, it'll tell you what their ISP is in atmosphere and out.
So do I want... Is the atomic... Oh, what?
Sorry. I just put in the biggest engines I could find. I need bigger decouplers. There we go. Not quite big enough, but whatever. That looks horrible. There's gotta be bigger ones than that. Whatever, let's go with it. I want to launch this rocket. Put that on so it doesn't fall apart. We'll put in another set of engines, shall we? Time we'll do the big ones again. And we'll go for some more decouplers because bling. Put on some boost stages. Who doesn't like boost stages? Oh, better balance it out. There we go. Now we need some caps on these things so they're not aerodynamically retarded. Don't want those.
They're like those. Funny shaped ones for those funny shaped pieces.
Do you have funny shaped pieces?
I guess, yeah.
Yeah, there's mostly funny shaped ones for your funny shaped pieces. I don't know. You're confusing me here. Stop it. And then because I'm an old school player on this, I have to have lots of struts. All the struts. Struts.
Aha! Found it.
Because it used to be when you played this, if you didn't have struts, your ship would fall apart. Do we want to bother with parachutes?
Nah. If you're not killing hurdles, you're not trying hard enough, right?
Well, you heard it here, folks. Tom hates Kerbals.
They signed up for this.
What?
Don't blame me.
It's their idea.
Right?
Oh, I already have one of those up there. Let's put... these funny cones on. Now let's put in lots of domes. Need all the domes. Not parachutes, just domes.
It's a monster, Cal.
You're a holy cow, Tom. Are you going to get off the ground with that?
No idea, mate.
You're supposed to be building a space rocket, not a
I built two.
Fireworks rocket.
Well, I built three. Hey, man. It's in, you know...
Okay, let's add, we need to do some control. We need controls.
Yeah, I know. I haven't done any of that yet. I still need to put in, strut connectors and all sorts. This thing's gonna die.
Hey, I said two. Why'd you put in four? Stupid game.
I'm gonna patch this thing up like Frankenstein. It's gonna be like staples holding it together all the way up. It's not gonna work though. It's gonna rip itself to pieces. It's gonna be great. Okay.
Wow, this one costs $500,000. What is yours at?
I don't know.
I can't see the price tag.
Is it down in the bottom left?
Yeah.
$74,000. So it's a true dirtmobile then.
What?
Apparently mine costs $74,890.
Apparently I'm using bigger parts than you.
Mind like, you, actually, is that parts. Price? I might not be looking at the right number. How do you get that number?
It's just what's in the bottom left. Mine's $508,302.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
That's what you have left.
I don't know.
Okay, so we need that has electric charge in it, but the ship doesn't, so we're gonna wanna put battery packs. And just throw them right there. So the thing doesn't run out of power right away. Then let's do
the derp is strong with this one.
Let's do those so that again we don't want to run out of power, because that sucks. You ever gotten into space and run out of power, guys? It's not fun, is it?
No.
We put in some solar panels. RCS, that's the other thing we need. We need RCS so that we can control our ship.
How'd you do that?
With RCS. I mean, not paying attention, Tom?
RCS? Where did you find that? Oh, is that one of these?
In the control setups.
RCS thruster blocks. Vernier.
Command and control.
What? Small inline reaction wheel. What? So could I put that underneath this? No, not really. Kind of. Oh, it needs a large one, right, okay. Large. Oh god, that's huge. Is that still gonna work? It looks awesome. Ah, there we go. Active inline stabilizer. Boom. What's this?
You know you have one of those in your
in the thing.
Well, I was gonna say you have one in your cockpit, but I don't see your cockpit. So there you go.
It's in the top there.
Yeah, he's got one, guys. He's good.
He's got two. He's a classy guy, you know. you need more RCS everywhere. What happens if I put vernier engines on the final stage? Let's do it.
You don't want to put it on your final stage. If you put them on,
yeah,
do them on your boost stages.
Oh, okay.
Your final stage should be able to get by on its own flywheel.
Place anywhere RCS. So now I just need to work out the staging on this crazy mess.
You built it right, or your staging would already be set.
If I'd what?
Mine's set.
Well,
my staging's already set. It just was in the order I built it. I don't know what crazy mumbo jungle you're doing.
Mine's backwards.
Tom, you may have slightly overcomplicated it.
Yeah, probably. Right, so basically, you really don't want to release that before
just...
the engines are on. Oh, no, it's fine.
Yeah,
I should just
be thinking in stages.
I've done it before. It's just not going to work out as like I hope.
Cool, guys. It's cool. I got this.
Because the thing is, what I forgot to do was put in those ringy bits that actually break off.
Yeah.
So I don't even know how I'm supposed to break them off. Because it's not just going to automatically release the whole thing. Oh, well, I need to find out, don't I?
If you put them in with symmetry, they'll break at the same time.
Okay, that's cool.
They'll be those three, like those three. I'm watching you move three around right now. Mm. Those three are all connected. So if you release one, all of them release. I guess that's your docking clamps.
Yeah, because
so whatever stage you want them in, you can put them in the same stage with your rocket, so that when you release your clamps, your rocket start. That's a pretty good one to go with. Speaking of stages, bam, stages. I like mine to go off at the same time as the rockets too.
So both rockets will go off and then the thing will come off. But then how do I get it to detach? That's the bit I don't remember.
Which part are you trying to get to detach?
Well, everything below the top part, because this has got loads of fuel in it. I'm hoping
Tom,
what?
You did not put any detach points in.
How do you put
unless it's wait go up to the one that's in zero. Let me see that one highlighted. It'll take a second, but
there.
I think zero is the one you have highlighted. That's your detachment. So wherever you put that, that's when everything will break off above zero. Not
right.
Above the number zero, just above them
on
the ship.
Okay, well, in that case, I need to attach the fuel for this as well then. Oops.
I'm just saying, like put that wherever you want it to be. Alright, I need to add RCS.
What has it just done?
I need to add fuel for RCS.
Oh, it just broke.
You can always control Z.
Oh, can you?
Yes. You can undo. Such a nice feature. Such nice.
Thank God. There. Right. I think that it will work. It should just use up all the bottom part to get me out of orbit, and then I've got the top part to actually blast off and try and get farther. And I'm gonna fail though. This is gonna be funny. I'm saving this thing. Well, I'm ready.
All right, let me. I got one last little adjustment to make.
I'm gonna fail so hard.
I'm ready to.
Okay, so looking at the chat. Look, Tom's
They're
doing this.
They're all screaming at you, aren't they?
Yeah, Tom's doing this like playing Starmade. Put as much engine as possible. I've just got this little bullet full of Kerbals. Do you know what, guys? Just for you, right? Can I turn symmetry off at this point? Right, if I take this one... Why did it still take two off? Whatever. I swear I put like. Hang on.
Okay, I think I'm ready.
I got something special.
Don't forget
for
to
the
save
guys.
It.
Hang on. I got something special for everybody. Oh man, why is it being stupid? Right. How do I get Kerbals on these external seats? Can you do that?
You have to do that on the launch pad. They won't go to external seats by assignment.
Right, well, I'll just put the things back on then.
Yeah, sorry.
That's okay, I thought that'd be funny, but you know. It's not one of those games, right. Okay. The dirt rocket's ready for launch. It only has two stages. I'm really a bit concerned about.
Yeah. Don't worry, Tom.
No, I've got it. This stage needs to be up here. Now I get why it's really weird.
Tom, I have one piece of advice for you.
Yeah, what?
It needs more wedges.
It does actually need more wedges. I concur with that. Entirely.
This is one of those games where aerodynamics actually matters, so adding wedges, good thing.
Yeah, well,
if you can figure out what the wedges are, I don't know.
I went for cups.
Today, folks, we have Bill Kerman and Jebediah Kerman. Apparently, they're brothers. I think everyone on this planet is related, which might explain things. You know what? I didn't put lights
none
on
of the
my ship.
In this vessel
I have to go back.
How do I crew it? What? It said none of the seats are crewed.
What? When you go to launch, it should just put crew in it.
No.
What mode are you in?
None of the seats are crewed.
What mode are you in?
Sandbox, I think.
All right, click on the little blue Kerbal bar at the top of your screen. Looks like a guy with a bubble around his head.
Got it.
Meanwhile, while you're doing that,
Jebediah and Bill. We'll take Jeb.
Yeah. You need to assign one of them. While you're doing that, I'm adding lights to my ship because it needs space lights so it can see in space. Come on, guys. You know I'm right.
You are right, though.
Yeah, man. If I can remember where the lights are.
Why is it playing Minecraft music now?
I don't know.
That was weird. My rocket is incredibly rickety. Okay? It's like swaying. It's swaying. Like, if I was down here, I'd be like, okay, everyone stand really far back. Oh my god, why is it so high off the floor? What? Okay, well, if I remember right, don't you have to turn the throttle up first and then hit the space bar? Yeah. Because the first thing I normally do is just drop it.
What you should do is wait for me.
Oh, I'm waiting. Don't worry. I'm waiting. Jebediah's just burning up here. He just can't wait to be the first ever Kerbal to die on exiting the atmosphere. You know, from, you know, friction or something. I don't know. Something tells me you're going to win this. Look at that rocket he's got.
I'm just adding shiny bits, guys, okay?
I can see that. So I've gone with a sort of triple-bodied thing, and he's gone with a space plane with four rockets and, like, two on each of those. There's eight boosters. I've got three and three. I'm feeling woefully underpowered at this point. But it's okay. Oh, you put wingy bits on. I'm jelly now. Alright, so what do you think, guys? How high do you think Calbiri is going to get?
Wait, is it nighttime?
Huh? No.
I may have to fast forward till it's nighttime.
Oh.
Nice. Yeah.
Really? Why does it look better?
Calm. Mm. Yes, it looks better, and keep in mind what you're
doing. Oh my god! Okay, I just did it a bit too fast. It went day-night cycle, like, real fast.
Can anyone in the chat tell us why Tom needs to wait for night?
Okay, it's nighttime. Is it because the lighting? Or is it because mine's going to look really crappy and yours is going to look like all Star Trek and lens flares?
Well, also, you're trying to launch away from the sun, so maybe launch away from the sun.
Oh, clever man. I didn't even think of that.
Are you ready?
I think so.
You got your push R to activate your
RCS.
Your adjustment. Yeah. And then throttle up, and then just push space when you're ready.
Throttle up is what?
Shift. And control, left shift and left control throttles up
I'm
and down.
I'm wobbling.
All right, you want to do a countdown?
Okay.
Yeah, wobbling happens.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go. I'm gone, baby.
I can't hear you.
Oh.
It's so loud.
I'm just waiting for it to catch up. Jeb's loving it. Right.
I hope that didn't deafen anyone.
I'm waiting for the...
I still can't hear you. I have to turn my volume down.
All right, okay. Oh, no. I think it... Wait. Uh-oh. Get out of there, man! It's all gone horribly, horribly wrong. Oh, God. Oh, God. This can't end well. Throttle down, throttle down. We'll just piggyback off this thing. Oh, crap. Crap. Quick! Break off, break
okay,
off.
Okay, I think I can hear you now. I had to turn
oh my God.
Down a lot.
Ah!
What did you want? I'm still sitting there on your...
I'm still going upwards somehow.
Somehow.
Somehow. What's going on? 300,000 and spinning. Right, I'm just going to hold. Okay, because I don't know. I'm not sure about this. How do you stop it from spinning?
How do you turn on lights? That's what I need to know.
Well, I think I made it to 300. No, I made it. Only made it to 30,000 meters. Yep, time to start falling. Oh, no. Press T. All right, I'm pushing T. Oh, is that all I had to do? Oh yeah, look, everyone in the chat. Press T. Press T. Press T. All right, guys. I think what I'll do is I'll do another launch because that's. I'm just falling now, Cal. I haven't even managed to leave. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't. Oh, dear.
Yeah.
I forgot to bracket my top four rockets. Now I'm all wobbly.
Oh, no.
Abandoned ship.
Yeah. That's what I've done. I've gone back to launch.
We're on to our little one. Let's see if I can at least get into orbit.
Okay.
Let's go for a polar orbit. Calm down. No, you calm down. Oh, that was a problem. I didn't have SAS on either. Ha! I launched without SAS. Take that. What do you guys think of that? I launched without SAS, and I made it up to 50,000 feet without problems.
That's not bad, mate. I only made it to 30.
Let's see if I can get into an orbit, and then I'll cancel it. My apex is 139,000. So, you know, unless I make orbit, that'll be my max. How do you turn lights on? There we go. Ha 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 ha.
Oh, I've spotted turned on the lights. I shouldn't have. No, no, no.
Yep. Do you see what's happening on mine?
You cheeky bugger, you're in orbit with a sick spaceship. No! Yeah, I think you win.
No, I haven't even made orbit yet. That's the sad thing.
Uh-oh.
Like, not even in orbit.
Come on, get away from it. Get away from it, bro. Get breakaway. I'm having docking mechanic problems. It won't come away. No! No, not again. Yes! I'm free! Free as a bird, as a bird. Wait, whoa, whoa, whoa. Steady on now, steady on. Steady on.
Oh boy, Tom. Your thing is just scary.
Mate, I don't even know how I've managed to do this, but I think I'm heading for something.
Did you? You're stuck.
No, I managed to get out. I got
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I got out.
I was like, you're towing a big turd around there. You're going to have trouble.
Okay, I'm at 600,000 meters. I do not know what I'm doing now.
Donut. I donut know.
How do you, I don't know how to control this. I keep on accelerating and decelerating because I'm trying to move the camera. Right. I think I've made something, but I don't know what I do next. How do you make it go in orbit? Your ship looks really cool, by the way. How the hell did you do that?
I may have played this game a lot.
I've made it up to a million meters. I don't know what that means.
There you go, Tom. I spread my wings.
How'd you get to that thing?
What thing?
M. Map.
Yeah, M for map.
Okay, so what have I got to do? I've got to click on this. Add maneuver.
Oh. What happened?
Oh, crap. That's not what I wanted. Ah, crap.
What happened to my engine?
That's not what
Flame out. Aww. I put in the wrong fuselage. I don't have fuel anymore. Well, Tom, you got me.
Really?
He's gonna crash. This one didn't make it. I'll have to go to launch too.
I don't know. I can't.
He's trying to do. You can't set up burns until you're out of orbit. You.
Oh really?
Crazy man.
Oh right. Yeah. I'm still in orbit.
Like what I'm watching you do right there. Like no, you're not even in orbit. You're just.
How far
you're
do
jumping
I have to
really
go?
High is what you're doing right
How
now.
How far do I
you
have to?
Have to go until that blue circle goes around the planet, then you're in orbit. Right now, you're just jumping really high.
Oh, damn it. Okay, but I'm going to use all my fuel in doing this.
Alright, well, everyone stuck around and watched me. So
oh, you've got wings.
We're going to have to crash this thing.
Hang on, I need to
see.
Yeah,
I got solar panels, man. Man, you need electricity in space. You gotta have solar panels or something. Oh, the glory!
Light it up nice,
it's
Cal.
It's beautiful! Holy crap! They survived re-entry. Oh my god. Oh, there they go.
See, I'm
Thor's
behind
hammer!
You
Boom!
Now.
that was awesome. Uh-oh. My game's gone.
No!
There, it's back.
Oh.
You've been watching my screen. You'll see it shortly. Oh, I keep forgetting. I have to deal with your screen delay too. Okay, let's go,
Oh, wow, there he goes.
To vehicle assembly.
How the hell did that not burn up?
I don't know, but they broke off once they actually got in the atmosphere, but...
I think I made it to 200,000.
Normally they'll burn up.
Is that where you're supposed to be, 200,000? And then do I have to look for the blue marker or the yellow marker?
Oh, Tom, I don't want to do this. I have to take my ship apart.
Is it the blue marker? It is, isn't it? I'm supposed to go for the blue marker.
This is just painful, guys. Take all these parts off because I put in the wrong thing. That. When you put in the fuselage, make sure it's not the airplane fuselage. That one doesn't work. You have to make sure you put in one with oxidizer in it, because, yeah, you need oxidizer. I put in this one right here. Mark 2 liquid fuel fuselage short. I need a Mark 2 rocket fuel fuselage short.
Oh wow, I am way off. What do I have to burn for? In 2 minutes. Is it the blue marker that you have to burn for? Light blue. I forget. I've got like 3 seconds of burn time and it says I've... Oh no, I've only got to burn for 1 second. I could do this. Mate, I need to know. Which angle is it for my maneuver? Because I'm looking at the blue marker.
Tom, what? Tom, you're not even on your first burn stage. You're on a second burn stage. You're going to crash into the planet before you loop around to do the yellow line.
Oh.
Just because you can make the lines work doesn't mean you're going to get the ship to do it.
Oh. So I need 1 second of burn time.
Sorry.
To die. Oh well.
Yeah, you don't even have enough to orbit right now. You have to get up to about 2,000 meters a second to orbit. You're not going to manage that.
Let's do something crazy then.
And, light bulbs, that's what we're adding. Light bulbs.
Yep, starting to fall. Time.
Speed. I'm really sorry if that sneeze made it through.
That's all right. Splash down.
I tried to mute it in time, but didn't manage. I don't think.
Jeb's having a great time. Nice. Mission accomplished.
Hey, look at that. I got all my parts to go back without breaking. I win. I win. I mean, good luck, Tom. All right.
What's this?
Are you ready to try again?
Yes.
Or do you want to make more modifications?
I'm gonna use a stock one.
I'll let you have that third. Oh, you're gonna use a stock one.
Yeah, Kerbal. I'll use a stock one this
okay.
time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I see how it is. Okay.
Hey, I've got to do the Hunter Primal tonight, so.
No excuses.
You gotta do it now. No, but this is the way. This is actually pretty good. You can do multiplayer like this. I'd do this again. Oh, so okay. So R and 1T. See, I wish
80,000. Tron there is generous. As soon as I break atmosphere, I crank over 90. Of course, I usually have enough height okay. that by the time I break atmosphere, I'm going to hit 100,000. But, yeah, there's some,
true.
Some tricks. Alright. I'm ready whenever you are. Of course, since you're cheating. see how simple they make it, though? Like, don't overdo it.
Okay.
Alright.
You ready?
Oh. I already gave away the surprise, whatever. I have to wait for nighttime, though.
Okay.
Come on, son, go down.
Alright. Ready?
There you go, Tom. Yeah, you go ahead and count down.
3, 2, 1. Oh my god, Calbiri, that is amazing.
Did you know you could put in colored lights?
No, I didn't know you could put in colored lights.
Yeah, wow. when you're building, you just right click on the lights and you can change the RGB. So, remove all the blue or all the green and you get purple. I was gonna wait till nighttime to pop it on, but then I'm like, oh, he'll see it before, you know, like, he'll see it. It's too late.
There's a 30-second delay, so it was perfect.
Con, I'm not overheating this time. Oh, it's so much smoother when you use T.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, and in the your top middle menu bar, right? On the right side, the very top button, it looks like a little light bulb that turns on any lights that you may have. I'm about to break 10,000 feet.
I get the feeling I should have actually ejected this. 8,000, not 80,000, he said. Whoops. And I should have actually launched these all off ages ago. There we go. Ah, oh, what an idiot. That's funny because I'm actually... Look, I'm just skimming the atmosphere. Cal, this is great. Oh dear. I don't think I'm really going up anymore.
Yours locked up on me again, sadly.
This is funny because I failed so spectacularly. I'm at 24,000, 25,000 meters. 8,000, yeah.
I'm still seeing 13. I'm reverting, on yours.
I'm reverting flight now.
Oh, that spoils all the fun. You gotta blow up.
Okay, you gotta bear
if anything
that,
else, right. Cut thrust and speed it up.
Alright.
Right?
Alright.
Like, that's half the fun, is when you fail, Kerbals die.
Go Kerbal, go Kerbal, go.
I was reading a thing, and apparently the concept of Kerbals came from one of the developers. His hobby was getting the little model rockets and, like, tying up these little tinfoil people to them, and he called them Kerbals, or they were called Kerbals or whatever. Mm. So, you guys all remember Sid from Toy Story? He grew up to make Kerbal Space Program. Just so you know, appreciation. Ooh. I'm on my final booster stage. Let's see how high it'll get me. Wow, this fuel is gonna last forever.
1 hour and 42 minutes. Let's try this again, shall we?
Should we do a polar orbit or? Let's do a standard orbit.
Staging on this thing. Steady on.
Oh boy. This is as close to Mushroom Fleet as I can get this ship for you, Tom.
Mate, it's beautiful. I wish I had that on full screen. It's sexy as hell.
What's messed up? How is it messed up?
Let me see it. It's beautiful, mate. It looks like something off EVE Online. It looks like a Crusader.
And I'm gonna get into orbit with my boost stage.
That's ridiculous. How the hell did you do that?
It's you're better off making the stages larger than the ship itself.
Right.
I mean, I didn't even do the efficient method with it. I could have. You just went through it on yours. Oh. Wait, as soon as that gets out of atmosphere. Stable orbit, cut thrust. I'm gonna get to 1,171,000.
No. Let's do the time warp, yeah. Uh-oh. We're out of control. Steady on now, partner. Oh, crap, I ran out of fuel. No, 500,000. No, not even that. 50,000 meters. What? Oh, but... that was the closest to an orbit I think I've ever made. Yeah, look, I'm gonna make it to the other side of the planet at least.
There you go.
Whee!
That's improvement, man. I crashed so many times, it was ridiculous.
Oh, wait. I've got more. Full power. Turns out, I had a secret rocket engine.
You know that's your return stage, right? To get back from the moon?
Ah, I'm not coming back. It's a one-way ticket. Oh, nice. I think I made it out of... Yes! Cal, I did it. I did it. Cut thrust. Cut thrust. Mate, I did it. Look. I'm leaving the system. Yes! Full power! Man, I'm going to go past Midness. This is epic. Right then, guys.
Yeah, keep in mind, leaving the Kerbal system is not leaving the system.
Is it not?
Just throwing that out there. Oh, no, no, it's not.
But I think that I should be able to now make it to deep space. I can explore deep space with my little rocket. I'll try and find some fuel, maybe.
Yeah, you do that.
Maybe there'll be a shop somewhere. Do you know where any shops are, Calbiri? Gah! There's no shops in this system. Gah! Goodbye, cruel Kerbal. Kerbin. I got a parachute. I don't need a rocket to land. It's all good. One-way trip. Jebediah is stoked. Bob can't wait. Bill's worrying about how they're going to procreate. And that's pretty much how it goes.
Oh, I only have to achieve another 6,000 delta. I think I might be able to pull that off. Alright, and we got... Ooh, we're not waiting 1 hour.
I'm slowly leaving the Kerbal system. Wait, let's give it a little bit of a boost. It's not really going to make any difference, is it? No. There we go. I made it orbit, Cal. Well, kind of.
Nice.
Well, it's not really a sustainable orbit or anything.
It's elliptical?
Let's see. I'm going to be orbiting the sun just between Eve and some unknown object, which is huge. But I'm going to go past that. So whatever it is, I'm going to get to find out what it is. Is that Kerbin? What's all this stuff over here? It says Class E, huge, and all this business.
Those are asteroids.
Oh, right. Oh my god! Mate, is it possible that I can correct my orbit and head into the sun?
You can. I don't know if you can, but it's possible.
Right.
The capability to do so, I don't know. I don't know if your ship can do it. You know what I mean? Like, it takes fuel to do stuff, and at the point you're at, you might not have enough to do much. Of course, the lighter you get, the more nimble you get, so... Alright, guys. We're doing a slingshot around Kerbin.
Oh, wow.
Yep. We're going to skim right by the planet, and we're going to use it to just launch us. We're going at almost 3,000 meters a second, and we have to pile on another 6,200, and we'll leave the system. And 15 seconds.
Oh, wow. I'm watching it now. I just pulled your window out of it.
4, 3, 2, 1, go! Full thrust. Been full thrust a while ago, but whatever. I'm going away from the sun. That's all that really matters.
Yeah, you're gonna win, because I'm on an orbit with the sun now. So the furthest I can go is my furthest orbit. You know, I can't get any further away.
Good thing I remember to attack my solar sails before I jettisoned my pods.
You have solar
sails?
Yeah,
now we're gone. Well, no, the
panels.
Yeah, the panels.
Oh, yeah.
Not quite leaving on the trajectory I was hoping for, but all we have to do now is avoid hitting an asteroid on the way out. Not likely, but you never know, right?
That stage you had was beautiful, by the way. It left like a flower on the horizon. Very space.
Oh, it was all shiny.
So
and
space.
Purple.
Can has.
Bill and Jebediah are gonna go do their thing in wherever the next system is. That would be really cool if Kerbal had other solar systems. There's mods for it, apparently.
Escape vector.
Oh, I'm upside down.
Is that a problem?
Not really. Just camera orientation. I was upside down. Not like I can't just rotate and, you know, get past it.
Yeah, you're way beyond me now. Way beyond.
We're approaching 500,000 meters.
Yeah, I'm at 5,000.
Our trajectory is not yet out of the system. We're pushing it, though. This orange line is our maximum. So we'll reach... Our apoapsis right now is 55 billion and quickly climbing. I don't know if I have enough fuel to get the other... I am getting lighter as I go, though, so I think I just might make it, Tom.
Whoa.
I sound like Darth Vader. What? I will take that as a compliment. Darth Vader sounds cool. Tom's like, I don't even care about my ship anymore. We're watching Cal.
Pretty much. I've got a chance of making for Moho. Or Eve, because the orbit intersects, but it'll take like 5,000 years.
Elo, look at that. I could almost go to Jewel if it wasn't on the wrong side of the system.
No, you win by a lot. It's insane. You've won by like...
No, it's not a point of winning though. We're trying to leave the system, remember?
Oh, it's true. Yeah, it's true.
Ah, the breathing sounds. That's because I'm not using push to talk right now. And, yeah. People breathe. Sorry.
Whoa, you're gonna make it to frickin' the next planet? Damn.
Nah, man, I'm already, well, I haven't gotten past ELO, but, I've already gone past the orbit of Jewel, or I will go past it. I have enough velocity to do that now. I don't think I'm going to escape the system. I just don't have enough... I don't have enough fuel left. Maybe if I'd started off with, you know, no monopropellant. Oh, there we go. That's sun, right?
a bit better.
Ah, oh, that's cool looking. Yeah, I'm gonna be a couple. Not a couple thousand. A little under 2,000 meters a second shy.
Really? What, are you ending up back to the sun as well?
Oh no, man. I never went towards the sun.
Oh.
My orbit shouldn't ever go lower than Kerbal is in the gravity well. Oh, and now I'm all out. So we're going to switch tactics here. Go to docking. We're going to eke out every last meter a second we can.
Why are you spinning?
I was bored.
I thought so.
And now I'm blasting my RCS because, you know, I'm so close. Damn it. Maybe I'll get another 50 meters a second before I run out of RCS.
So all I managed to do was get pulled round the sun closer to the sun than Mercury. Or as close, you know, somewhere between Mercury and Venus. I didn't even actually get further away. You know, yeah, I broke orbit, but it took me so long that I ended up heading back towards the sun. So I didn't even make it.
You flew in the wrong direction.
Yeah.
I told you not to fly towards the sun. I'll get up to 125 billion meters.
No. Well, you win. It's a good game though. Look at that.
I still wish I could break.
Whoa.
I wanted to break the system. That was my goal.
But still, damn.
I feel like I failed.
No, not at all, because that's the far. I've never even managed to get further than the moon.
I think if I'd left the RCS off, that might have gained me enough weight difference to have made it. Like, well, 1 pound makes a huge difference at this point.
Well, I think that's that.
Oh, well.
Yeah, well, GG. Thanks, Cal. Thanks to everybody watching. Just a bit of random fun. And coming right up will be Hunter Primal. So, yeah, if you want to watch me getting eaten by feathered dinosaurs, stay tuned.
Dinosaurs!
See you soon.